Can you tell me something about your impression, say, with the communication with Landau?
Oh, Landau. Yeah, well, Landau is, I consider, one of the greatest physicists, theoretical physicists of the 20th century. I compare Landau very much with Feynman. He actually did very great similarities between the two. They're both, you know, both absolutely experts in the mathematics, developing the theory. At the same time, they both have a physical spirit to understand what is going on, like nobody else. So they're very similar. Landau, of course, that is as the physics is concerned. Character, they are different. I mean, Landau is in character, they have some similarities. But Landau was great. I was always very interesting to talk to be together with. I was with Landau together in Kharkov in the early 30s, in 32, where he was not known yet, but it was a great pleasure to work with him. He was, of course, very strongly against the Stalin regime. I always was afraid to be together with him because he was open. He said, he expressed his views very openly. It was dangerous. Actually, he spent almost a year in jail. But he was a great man. And not in everything, you see, there is no field in physics, almost, in which he did not contribute to turbulence and liquid, superconductivity, superliquid, superfluidity. He has this tremendous insight in so many things, just like Feynman, which is absolutely unadmirable. And then he had this terrible accident, you know, where he lost his short-term memory. And he wrote his wonderful books, very like Feynman, right? Feynman, these three volumes of Feynman physics, and then you have the six volumes of Feynman and what's his name?
Landau,
where it is said that no word in these books is written by Landau, and no idea is conceived by Lifshitz.
That's right.
But they are excellent books.
That's right.
So,
you consider that Landau Lifshitz series of physics book still one of the most the best quality available, or?
Yeah, I mean, you see, there are, let me say, the first great series of textbooks was Sommerfeld. You know, I don't know how many volumes, which was, I learned from these books in the 20th century. And then came Landau Lifshitz. They are still, I think,
good.
Excellent books. And since then, well, and then the Feynman books, they're a different kind.
That's
Feynman
right.
Feynman books are more elementary, but very valuable. And I think there's nothing like those three books in the literature. There are lots of books of theoretical physics, but none is so deep and so physical.
This is taped on June 17 during the visit of Professor Weisskopf to the Institute for Advanced Physics Studies in La Jolla, California.